for 15B, I got to change, I got a typo there. We actually want the line y equals 15. We want something that's way up and above our zone. Remember our zone, it was that wedge shape and it maxed out, I believe, at y equals 8. So we're looking at y equals 15. So this is something which is above our zone. And if that's the situation, then now what we're looking to do is have our little radius is now our large radius. So the x cubed will be first and the 2x squared will be second. And we have to subtract these functions from k. K is 15, so we have 15 minus x cubed wrapped in squared, and then 15 minus 2x squared, and that's also squared. We still have the whole thing with the differential, so we still got our dx as so, and then our bounds are 0 to 2, and our coefficient is pi. All right, so I apologize, it should be a 15, not a 5. And what that does is, again, it changes. Notice that the x cubed is first, whereas before the x cubed was second. Right? We have to change our functions in order to have our larger radius squared minus our smaller radius squared. Oftentimes, you just need to write the functions. You don't necessarily need to solve the integrals. But if you do need to solve the integral, you can find out if something's off, if you're backwards, based off of if you're getting some kind of negative result. Because obviously we know volume is positive, so if you're getting a negative result, well, chances are you've got something reversed.